I'm going to speak on comparative evaluation of effect of post-operative patching versus no patching after strabismus surgery. Patching of eye is routinely done after all the surgeries, whether the surgery is done under general anesthesia or under peribulbar block. However, different authors has view that non-patched eye has less pain, redness, and other components of inflammation. However, no proper study has been done in this regard. The advantages of patching are it protects the eye from trauma. It as most of the surgeries are done under peribulbar block, many times orbicularis oculi is also paralyzed, so it prevents against corneal exposure keratopathy. Patching also prevents oozing from the wound and is hence less apprehensive to the patient. The disadvantage is that patching increases local warmth, which results in vasodilation and increase in the inflammatory mediators. Also, it interferes with administration of topical antibiotics and increases distress in emotionally upset patients. So, it is very important to patch when the surgery is done under peribulbar block, but it is doubtful where to patch the eye when it is done under general anesthesia. In RP center, currently, after squint surgery, we used to patch one eye and we leave the other eye unpatched when the surgery is done under general anesthesia. So now in our study, we observed that which eye has less signs of inflammation in the post-operative period. Different authors has done study in this regard. Jiang et al. Has compared pain after patching in patched versus non-patched eye, and he found that post-operative patching is not necessary for reducing pain and the risk of infection. Mayer S. et al. Has also compared between patched and unpatched eye, but in cataract surgery, he found that after cataract surgery, eye patching could be unnecessary. However, the disadvantage of limitation of study done by Jiang et al. Was that he didn't do bilaterally symmetrical surgery. Surgery was done in different subjects and compared among different subjects. And we know that pain threshold is different in all persons, so the result can be biased. So the lacuna in knowledge is that no study has been conducted for comparing pain and inflammation in patched versus non-patched eye after symmetrical strabismus surgery. So we did that. It was a prospective study done for 15 months in RP Center AIMS. Age group was 5 to 15 years. After taking consent after surgery, the eye was patched till next morning and the other eye was left unpatched. Mass evaluation was done on the next day after 1 week and after 1 month. So we included children between the age of 5 to 15 who were fit for general anesthesia and were undergoing bilaterally symmetrical surgery. Children with mental retardation or any ocular pathology were excluded from the study. These were the different parameters we compared. Pain was compared on a numeric rating scale. It was scaled from 0 to 10 and verbal statement was given by the child according to the severity of pain. Lid edema was classified on VISA inflammatory score, which is used for thyroid orbitopathy. Grade 1 was, score of 1 was given when lid edema was present, but it was not causing overhanging of the tissues. And score of 2 was given when lid edema was present and it was causing overhanging of the tissues. For chemosis, if chemosis was beyond the gray line, we scored it 2, and if it was less, then it was scored as 1. Congestion, all four quadrants were, I was divided into four quadrants, and if there were few vessels injected, a score of 1 was given. If it was diffusely injected, a score of 2, and severely injected, a score of 3 was given, and summation of all the quadrants were done. Similarly, subconjunctival hemorrhage, I was divided into four quadrants. If there was less than 1 mm of hemorrhage seen on slit lamp, then a score of 1 was given, 1 to 3 mm, a score of 2, and more than 3 mm, a score of 3 was given. If there was tenens prolapse, a score of 2 was given to wound gaping, and if the suture were broken, a score of 3 was given. Dalen formation, if Dalen formation was there, a score of 1 was given. We used generalized estimating equation for quantitative data, and for qualitative jet test was done. P value less than 0.05 was taken as significant. Total 100 patients actually 200 eyes were enrolled. Bilateral MR surgery was done in 29 cases, LR in 21, horizontal plus inferior oblique in 32, and horizontal plus superior oblique in 18 eyes, 18 patients. So we saw that the passed eye has more pain and pain compared to the unpassed eye, and the value was statistically significant on the next day of surgery. However, no patients complained of pain after 1 week and 1 month of surgery. Similarly, conjunctival congestion was more on the next day and after 1 week in the unpassed eye. It was more in the passed eye, and it was statistically significant. Subconjunctival hemorrhage was also more in the passed eye. However, the result was not significant. But in case of surgery which was involving inferior oblique muscle, p-value was significant even in case of subconjunctival hemorrhage between the passed and the unpassed eye. There were more lid edema in the passed eye and more chemosis in the passed eye. However, the result was not significant. This is a graphical representation. We can see immediately after surgery, they were both eye were similar looking. Up next post of the left eye has much more congestion and subconjunctival hemorrhage compared to the right eye. And even after 1 week, there are more congestion in the left eye. After 1 month, no difference was seen. Similarly, this is the second case, right eye was passed, and there is much more congestion in the right eye compared to left. Even after 1 week, after 1 month,
conclude,
no difference was
seen. Time up.
So we also compared which muscle surgery has more pain and congestion. We saw that maximum pain.
To conclude, sir,
patching results in much more pain and congestion compared to the unpatched eye. So we recommend non-patching of the eye after surgery done under general anesthesia. Effect of not patching of any eye after strabismus surgery should be done in further studies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next. Muralidhar Rajamani.
No, as it may lead to biasing, we didn't put any drops. No topical drops was started till next morning.